Somewhere in the dark canvas of deep space, billions of light years from home, a faint glow flickered across the instruments of a radio telescope. It didn't resemble a galaxy, a quasar, or the residue of a long-dead star. Instead, it appeared as a perfect, ghostly ring, a colossal circle of energy that seemed to hover in the cosmic void, almost taunting our understanding of the universe. The astronomer who first laid eyes on it, Anna Kapinska, could only label it with three letters that captured the feeling best: WTF. Before we dive into this powerful story, make sure you subscribe and turn on all notifications, because what you're about to hear will change the way you see everything. Welcome back to Beyond the Stars. At first glance, it looked like smoke, a hazy, luminous ring adrift among the galaxies. But this was no ordinary puff of cosmic gas. Whatever it was, it spanned nearly a million light years across. For perspective, that's 10 times the diameter of our own Milky Way. This object, and a handful of others like it, would come to be known as odd radio circles, ORCs. And to this day, they remain one of the most baffling mysteries modern astronomy has ever stumbled upon. For years, we've been listening to space, tuning into the silent symphony of the cosmos. But every now and then, a note hits that doesn't belong, a sound, a signal, a shimmer that defies everything we thought we understood. ORCs are exactly that. Ritweeds and facts are all and all in 1 second of the real ORI, the sound of 10 million ARCs. Each one seems to whisper from beyond the edge of comprehension, forcing us to question not just what they are, but how such colossal structures could even exist. And now, we've detected another one. Another WTF signal, another ring a million light years wide, and once again, it's rewriting the rules. This latest ORC joins a short but growing list of these enigmatic giants. Only 5 have been confirmed so far, and each new discovery deepens the mystery. How can something so vast, so luminous, exist in such silence? What kind of power sculpts a circle of energy on this scale, glowing faintly across billions of light years, like a ripple frozen in time? It all began with a revolution in technology. For most of the 20th century, radio astronomers could only scan tiny patches of sky at a time, cataloging mere hundreds of thousands of radio sources. Then came a new generation of instruments, telescopes that could see more, faster, deeper. Chief among them, the Australian Square Kilometer Array Pathfinder, or ASKAP, a sprawling network of 36 dishes set in the remote wilderness of Western Australia. ASKAP's gift is its wide gaze. With its phased array feeds, it can image enormous swathes of the sky in a single shot, 30 square degrees at once, about the area of 154 moons. It was built for one purpose: to map the universe in radio light like never before. Under the Evolutionary Map of the Universe project, fittingly called EMU, scientists hope to expand humanity's cosmic census from 2.5 million radio sources to merely 70 million. No one knew exactly what they'd find in that flood of data. But as Professor Ray Norris, one of the project's leaders, put it, "We were bound to be surprised." And surprised they were. While browsing through ASKAP's early images, Kapinska noticed something strange. Amid the countless specks of distant galaxies and active nuclei, a perfect circle stood out, bright at the edges, dim in the center. It didn't match anything in the astronomical catalog. It wasn't a supernova remnant. It wasn't a radio jet. It wasn't supposed to be there. Kapinska tagged the image with WTF, a mix of shock, curiosity, and scientific awe. She shared it with her colleagues, and soon, more circles began appearing in the data. A second one, a third. By the time the dust settled, they realized they weren't looking at artifacts or telescope glitches. These things were real. The universe had painted glowing halos across the void, and we were finally seeing them. The first ORC, nicknamed ORC 1, sits roughly 5 billion light years away. Invisible light, it's invisible, a ghost. But in radio wavelengths, it blazes like a ring of fire, spanning nearly 2 million light years from edge to edge. That's big enough to swallow 20 Milky Ways whole. At its center lies an elliptical galaxy, visible in both infrared and optical data. That coup, a galaxy sitting dead in the middle of the ring, hinted that these ORCs weren't random. Whatever caused them, it seemed tied to the galaxy within. But what? Astronomers began sketching theories. Perhaps, they thought, it was the aftermath of a cosmic cataclysm, the merger of two supermassive black holes. When black holes collide, they unleash waves of unimaginable energy, distorting space itself. Such a shockwave, racing outward through intergalactic gas, could accelerate electrons and ignite a sphere of radio light, a cosmic blast, still glowing eons after the event. Another idea, maybe ORCs are just the ghostly lobes of radio jets from active galactic nuclei, immense beams of plasma launched by matter spiraling into a central black hole. Normally, we see these jets from the side, forming hourglass shapes. But if we're looking straight down the barrel, those twin beams could overlap, forming the illusion of a perfect circle. Or perhaps, some argued, these are relics of galactic renewal, echoes from a starburst event, when a galaxy births millions of stars in a sudden frenzy. As those young suns flare, die, and explode, they fill the galaxy with stellar winds and shockwaves, expanding outward to form a vast, glowing shell, the final breath of a cosmic nursery. Each theory fits part of the puzzle, yet none explain it all. Why so few ORCs? Why the perfect symmetry? Why the faint, uniform brightness? The more astronomers looked, a stranger it seemed. Then came the Cloverleaf ORC, a sprawling, clumpy formation over 300,000 light-years wide, resembling a flower blooming in radio light. This one was closer, just 600 million light-years away, and for the first time, astronomers observed it not just in radio, but in optical and X-ray wavelengths too. They even detected oxygen gas stretched across 130,000 light-years, shocked, heated, and glowing. One team proposed it was indeed a starburst termination shock, the dying echo of a galaxy that once exploded with life. Another team saw something else, the messy scars of a galactic collision. Two clusters of galaxies crashing together could stir up shockwaves large enough to haint the cosmos in radio light. Still, questions remain. Why do some mergers create ORCs while others vanish without a trace? Are we seeing a brief stage in a long cosmic life cycle, or a rare event frozen in time? Every new ORC seems to rewrite the script. ORC 2 and ORC 3, twin circles hovering close together, hint at a shared origin, yet one is bright and ringed, the other dim and disc-like. ORC 5 features not one but two central galaxies, possibly locked in gravitational embrace. It's as if each one carries its own signature, a unique echo of some vast, violent, or beautiful event. What's certain is that they're rare. Despite mapping millions of radio sources, we've only found a handful of ORCs. That scarcity suggests we're catching something fleeting, perhaps a cosmic ripple that fades after a few hundred million years, leaving only whispers behind. And yet, every whisper tells a story. A story of galaxies colliding, stars bursting, black holes merging, and forces beyond imagination reshaping the universe. When Kapinska labeled that first image WTF, she captured the essence of discovery. Because science often begins there, with wonder, confusion, and the courage to admit, we don't know, but we're learning. With each observation, each simulation, we inch closer to the truth. ASKAP, Meerkat, and other telescopes are now combing the skies with greater precision than ever before, machine learning algorithms sift through terabytes of cosmic data, searching for faint rings hidden in the noise. Even citizen scientists are joining in, helping to classify millions of radio sources through projects like Radio Galaxy Zoo. Somewhere in that ocean of information, the next ORC is waiting. Another ghost ring, another riddle from the depths of time. What will it tell us? Perhaps that galaxies live longer, wilder lives than we ever dreamed. Perhaps that black holes do more than devour, that they sculpt, ignite, and echo across the void. Or perhaps ORCs are signs of something we've yet to imagine, a new kind of cosmic phenomenon that challenges the very boundaries of astrophysics. For now, the signals keep coming, soft, circular, and strange, radio whispers from a million light years wide. We're receiving another WTF moment from the cosmos, another call from the dark. And though we don't yet know who or what is speaking, one thing is certain. The universe isn't done surprising us. Each ORC reminds us how small we are and how vast the unknown still is. Somewhere out there, enormous rings drift silently through space, remnants or revelations of forces far beyond our reach. They may be the echoes of creation or the footprints of destruction. Whatever they are, they're a message, not in words or codes, but in awe. A reminder that even in the age of supercomputers and space telescopes, the universe still has the power to make us say, with all the humility of discovery, WTF. This is far from over. New details are unfolding every day. So hit subscribe and stay with us as the truth continues to surface.